I am Talveen from buildwoofunnels.com, and in this video I am talking about one-click upsells or one-time offers in WooCommerce. But the very fact that you're watching this video tells me that your WooCommerce store is not your fun project, you're pretty committed to its growth. It also tells me that you are getting some sales, but you definitely know that you can do a lot more to scale it up. And this is the time when you want to implement systems in your business that can help you generate more profits that you can finally sit back and enjoy. Well, if that speaks to you, stick around because I'm going to tell you what one-click upsells are and whether you need them in your business or not. So first things first, what is a one-click upsell exactly? Now, as the name suggests, it is an upsell offer that you make to your customers just after they purchase a product from your website or your store. So they fill out their payment details on the checkout page, click place order or proceed to checkout, and right before they are shown the thank you page, you basically hijack their flow and show them relevant upsell and downsell offers. So they enter an invisible backend funnel. I call it invisible because it is not visible from anywhere else on the website. They have to make a purchase to enter this funnel. So they are shown a set of relevant upsell and downsell offers which are very well aligned with the main purchase that they just made. Well, now you may be thinking, why do I have to wait all the way till the checkout to make them upsell offers? Why not make them pre-purchase? Well, you can make them pre-purchase, but the thing is that you do not know what they are buying. Well, they may be simply browsing those products, they may have multiple tabs open on their browser, and they are not yet sure of what they are buying, right? So you're not in a position to make them a relevant offer. Also, what's important to understand is how McDonald's does it. Now, while you're choosing your burger, that's not when they come and say, would you like fries with that? It's only when you are done making your selection and now you're finally at the counter with your wallet in your hand or with your card in your hand and ready to swipe. You're not going to change your mind at that point, right? So that is when the person at the counter says, would you like fries with that? Or would you like a drink to go with that, right? Because you have already decided what you're buying. You have already placed your order, right? So that is the difference between pre-purchase and post-purchase. And also, there are three major psychological triggers which work like a charm in case of post-purchase upselling that do not work in case of pre-purchase upselling. To name them, number one, exclusivity of the offer. Now, you can make an exclusive offer post-purchase. You can offer them a discount, or a special deal like buy three, get one free, or buy two, get two free. You can present these exclusive offers behind the checkout gate. So these offers are not available elsewhere on the website, right? Elsewhere on the store. But over here, when they're on this page, you can stop them and say, wait, your order is not complete yet. Or here's a perfect complement to your order, and then pitch them relevant offers. So that is one thing. Exclusivity of the deal, it's not available elsewhere. Number two, the relevance of the offers. Now, the offers can be extremely relevant here because now you know what they have bought. Because now you understand them way better than you did before they made the purchase, right? And thirdly, urgency. Urgency works like a charm, I cannot emphasize enough. So on your upsell offer page, you can point them to the countdown timer, which is ticking. So they know that they only have a limited time to take action. And if they do not move swiftly in that direction, they will miss out on the opportunity. So the fact that the opportunity comes with a timer, comes with an expiry time, that itself makes it irresistible. That itself makes it worth taking up on. Well, now I want to share with you three promising outcomes of one-click upsells, and then you can decide for yourself whether you need them in your business or not. Number one, they increase your average order value. Now, average order value is a very, very interesting metric. In fact, you should be more focused on it than you are on your traffic. I'll tell you why. Now, average order value is the average amount that a customer spends on your business. In order to calculate yours, divide your revenue in a month by the number of orders that you've got in that month. And the number that you will get is your average cart value or your average order value. Now, every time you acquire a new customer, you basically pay for them. So you pay your advertising channels to get them to convert into a customer, right? So you want them to spend maximum amount of money on your store. You want their average order value to be really high so that you can not just cover up for the cost that you paid to acquire them, but also make healthy profits. Now, here's an example of an online supplement store. Their average order value is $120. And as customer acquisition cost, which is cost of acquiring one customer, wait for it, is also $120. So, well, this is basically a zero-sum game. Why would you like to play this game where you're basically just breaking even, right? Well, you wouldn't like to play this game. So that is why what this supplement store owner smartly did was that he placed relevant upsell and downsell offers post-purchase, and because of which he has managed to bump up his average order value to $250. And suddenly, this becomes a highly profitable business. In fact, it is a seven-figure business. The second promising outcome of one-click upsells is that they increase your return on ad spends. Now, if you run advertisement, you know that ROAS or return on ad spends is the most important metrics that you should be tracking to understand the performance of your ads. So what one-click upsells do is that they give you excellent return on your ad spends. Now, let me give you an example of a small store owner. Now, he spent about £373 on running ads, and he sold products worth £800. Now, that's not a very good ROAS, right? I mean, that's good enough, but here's what he did. So he got his one-click upsell offers in place, because of which he sold £1,400 worth more products with his back-end funnel alone. So about £1,400 there, £800 from front-end products, that's about £2,200 from an ad spend of £373. That's pretty decent, isn't it? Now, you must step back and understand that this store owner did not actually present very highly priced upsell and downsell offers. These were just £10, £15, £20, hence making them no-brainer buys. So again, if anyone just came to spend, like, let's say £30 in the store, they ended up just bumping up their average order value themselves just by adding one £10 or upsell offer, or just by accepting another £15 upsell offer, right? And that's how he systematically increased his average order value. The number third and the most important outcome of a one-click upsell in your business would be that they help you lower your front-end product cost. Now, your front-end product is obviously the most important part of your upsell funnel, because they help attract your people towards your back-end funnel. So the more competitively your front-end product is priced, more people you can expect to sell it to, and more people you can direct towards your back-end funnel. Now, here's an example from a sales consultant who sells an ebook just for $5.60. Now, that's pretty competitively priced. And still, he's able to make himself visible everywhere on Facebook. So how is he even advertising everywhere? Where is he getting the money from? From the back end of his funnel. Now, after they are done buying the ebook, he pitches them really relevant products, for example, masterclasses and courses, which are perfectly aligned with the front end product, which is the ebook, right? They're a perfect extension of that. So people who would be interested in learning from the ebook would also be interested in learning more, expanding their learning from the courses. And this entire system of back-end and front-end products club together has increased his average order value to $61. Now, he's able to make approximately $3.50 to $4 for every $1 spent on ads. So you can very well imagine what it would mean without the back-end funnel and what it really means with the back-end funnel in place. How is that for an outcome? Pretty good, isn't it? That's it in this lesson. I really hope that these results inspire you and you cannot wait to create results like these for your own business. In my next video, I'm going to show you how you can build your very first upsell funnel using Upstroke by buildwhofunnels.com. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you like this lesson, do let me know in the comments below. I would love to hear from you. And also share with me any thoughts that you have about one-click upsells so that we can exchange ideas and brainstorm a bit. So stay tuned for my next lesson, for my next video. I will see you next time. That is me, Tavleen, signing off, and happy upselling.